वेलकम बैक डियर स्टूडेंट्स, दिस वीडियो डिस्क्राइब क्लास 9 ज्योग्राफी लेसन नंबर 10 अर्बनाइजेशन मॉडल 2। बिफोर प्रोसीडिंग फर्दर फॉर मॉडल 2, लेट्स टेक क्विक रिकैप व्हाट वी हैव स्टडीड इन अ लेसन नंबर 10 अर्बनाइजेशन इन मॉडल 1। इन द बिगनिंग वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट द कंसेप्ट ऑफ अर्बनाइजेशन। Due to the growth and the development in the form of the earlier villages changes, the village transforms into a city or the town. Gram Panchayat gives way to municipal council or municipal corporation. Infrastructure development takes place. As a result, more hospitals, schools, colleges, banks, transport services, market, supply of basic needs develop. And a village is transformed into a city or the town. Also, we have studied that when a region develops in terms of infrastructure and increase in population, it transforms from a rural areas into an urban areas is known as urbanization. Also, we have studied about the factors which are responsible for the growth of urbanization, factors such as industrialization, trade, mechanization and technology, transport and communication, and migration. In our previous module, we have studied that industrialization plays an important role for the growth of the urbanization. Development of industries in a region is an important factor contributing towards urbanization. Increase in industries leads to increase in the hope of the people who are attracted to find job opportunities in the industries and lead a city life. This increases the speed of urbanization. Student, please remember that in 19th century, Mumbai grew rapidly because of the large-scale textile mill started. Many fishing villages became part of the Mumbai metropolitan area because of the industrialization and urbanization. Then we took information about transport and communication. In a region where transport facilities like roadways and the railways well developed, urbanization of small rural settlement occurs rapidly. With the development of transport, means of communication also developed. Telecommunication and mass media also well developed. Then trade. Urbanization takes place in such region which facilitate trade activities and the services. A place in a region is sometimes favorable in terms of transport, loading, unloading and storage of goods. This leads to the development of trade and related services like business, banks, credit societies, godown, coal storage and so on. Also, we have studied that migration is a major factor affecting urbanization. People migrate from rural areas to urban areas due to the attraction of urban life and good infrastructural facilities. Then, mechanization and the technology is another factor contributing for the growth of the urbanization. In recent decades, use of mechanization and technology in activities like agriculture and industry related to agriculture has increased. Due to mechanization in agriculture, manpower in agriculture became less. As a result, this class of people started migrating towards the urban area for the job opportunities in an industries. So student, in our lesson number 10, urbanization in module 2, we are going to concentrate on effects of urbanization, advantages of urbanization, which includes social harmony, modernization, and amenities and facilities. Also, we are going to concentrate on the problems which are arising due to the urbanization, such as slums, traffic jams, pollution, and the crime. So, let's start our module 2. Now, let's begin our module 2 with more causes of the urbanization or the urban growth. Students, you all know that more and more people migrate towards the urban area for the various facilities, such as better food supply. In urban areas, people are getting better food supply and therefore more people get attracted towards the urban area. Also, in an urban area, people are getting better and advanced medical or the health facilities. As you all know that compared to the villages, more and more people comes to the urban area to avail better health facilities. Also here, people get employment opportunity. Most of the people get attracted for the growth and development in the industry. Here are the chances for the people to get the various employment. And the last one is the educational facility. Number of educational facilities are available in the urban area. As a result, more and more people get attracted towards the urban area to avail various facilities. Now, let's see about the effects of urbanization. Students, you all know that due to the growth in the urbanization, the features or the characteristic of a particular region goes on changing. We can experience the difference in a land use. Let's take one example to understand. The land under the agriculture is now utilized for the various purposes such as industries or residential use. While there are many advantages of urbanization, also there are some of the problems are also arising because of the growth of the urbanization. Now, let's discuss in detail. Now, let's see the positive side of the urbanization, that is, advantages of the urbanization. Advantages of the urbanization such as social harmony, modernization, and amenities and facilities. Let's discuss each one of them in detail. Let's see the first advantage of the urbanization, that is social harmony. Students, you all know that nowadays urbanization goes on increasing. There is an increase in secondary, tertiary and quaternary occupation in urban areas. As a result, economic activity also increases. These areas grow rapidly because of the various occupation. As a result, different cultural, social customs and traditions are exchanged as a people from different parts living together in the cities, and these create social harmony in the society. Now, here we have the another advantage of the urbanization, that is modernization. Students, you all know that in urban areas or inner cities, people migrate because of the various facilities which are available. Here, the people from different areas migrate. Their wisdoms, skills, and the knowledge is also exchanged very easily. These areas are the first to get advantage of updated knowledge and the literature. We can see now new projects related to industries and even for the businesses are also coming up in a cities. Urban settlement get an advantages of new ideas, updated technologies and technological facilities also. As a result, the standard of living also goes on increasing. Therefore, number of people get attracted towards the urbanization. Due to the urbanization, various amenities and the facilities are also developed in urban areas, such as transportation facilities, communication facilities, and various educational facilities, advanced and technology-based medical facilities or health facilities, fire brigade facilities, and so on. These are the important facilities people are getting in urban areas. Because of the good transportation facilities, journey of the people become very easier. Its positive effect is also seen on a flight transport, market, trade, and so on. Due to the urbanization, we can see that even educational facilities are well developed in urban areas. Many students come to urban areas especially to access the services of higher education like Pune city as well as in Mumbai. Medical facilities are also well developed in urban areas. To avail of these facilities, many patients and their family members also come from different parts and stay for a short period of time. Students, you all know that as there are many advantages of the urbanization, so are the disadvantages. Disadvantages also known as the problems of urbanization. The urbanization faces the problem such as slums, traffic jams, pollution, and crime. So let's learn in detail about the problems of urbanization. Slums in the cities are one of the major problems due to the urbanization. Let's see the problems of urbanization. Because of the urbanization, the population in the cities increasing rapidly, but the housing facility does not increase in the same proportion as the population. Most of the migrated people are economically weak. They cannot able to afford the housing price in the city. Migrated people have generally come for the employment, but it is not necessary that they will get the relevant job. Hence, the income is very low. So, such people build their temporary and the semi-structured houses in an open space. As you can see in this image, these houses are mostly illegal. They do not get the basic facilities from the local self-government. Facilities such as water, electricity, then toilet, and so on. The density of the houses is very high. Roads are narrow. There is a lack of basic facilities. These slums keep on increasing uncontrollably. This may give rise to the social as well as the health related issue. So the people, those who are living in the slums area, they are facing the problem of the health due to the insufficient water supply, unhealthy climate, even the lack of electricity. Now, the another problem arises because of the urbanization, that is traffic jam. Students, you are aware about the traffic jam. We all are facing the traffic jam in our day-to-day life. It's occur because as the cities grow, people start living in the outskirts and suburb of the city. People commute from the suburb to the center of the city daily because of the various purpose. So, as I told that people commute from the suburb to the center of the city for various purposes such as business and the industries, some travel for the trading purposes, job, better education, and so on. So the public transportation system is not sufficient. As a result, the number of private vehicles goes on increasing, and this leads to an increase in the traffic jam. It also increases the traveling time. Because of the traffic, people faces a lot of problem because of the traffic jam. Now, the another issues or the problem which are arising due to the urbanization, that is pollution. Pollution is a major problem in the cities. As all of you know that in our day-to-day life, we are facing the problem of pollution. So the pollution such as air pollution, noise pollution, and the water pollution. So such kind of pollution we can see clearly in our environment. It has adverse effect on urban life. As you can see in this slide, air pollution. Air pollution can lead to the asthma and other respiratory diseases. Then noise pollution can lead to the sleep disturbances, hearing problem, whereas the water pollution can lead to several waterborne diseases like typhoid and cholera. Increase in the population and the development of the cities, lack of facilities and breaking of the laws make the pollution a big problem. As cities goes on increasing, the problem of pollution is also goes on increasing. Now, let's see some of the measures to solve the problem of pollution which is arising due to the growth and the development of the urbanization. As all of you know about the air pollution occurs because of the growth of the vehicle as well as due to the industrialization. So, the problem of air pollution can be solved by switching from coal, oil to natural gas as a fuel in the industry. Whereas industrial area should be located at a safe place or the distances from the residential area. Whereas the problem of noise pollution can solve by reducing the voice volume. Industries can shut the door when using noisy machine. Whereas the people should avoid the increase in the volume of the horns, loudspeakers and so on. The problem of water pollution can be solved by sewage should not be allowed to mix with the water sources without getting treated. Avoid mixing industrial waste and effluent directly into the water sources. Daily household work should be avoided at the water sources. Now, the another major problem or the issue of the urbanization, that is crime. As all of you know that many people migrate towards the urban areas or the cities for the employment opportunities or the job. So the people who are migrated do not always find the employment in the cities. So people are trying to involve themselves in a various illegal ways to earn the money. Some of them look for the easy earning money through the illegal ways. This lead to an increase in the crime rate in the cities. They involve themselves in a crime in a various ways. This leads to a serious loss and order issues, bringing pressure on the police and the judicial system. Students, you all know that in our previous slides we have studied about the problems or the issues which are arising due to the growth of the urbanization. So the problems such as slums, traffic jams, pollution and the crime rate. Such problems are goes on increasing in the cities. Besides such problem, enormous increase in the land prices, struggle between the various groups also create the tension in the city life. This can disturb the social harmony of the city. Students, did you know about the smart city? Let's see what is a smart city. To update the cities using information technology and for handling the assets of the urban areas easily, a scheme is called Smart City came into existence. The main aim of this program is to collect information regarding various aspects of the city through the use of ICT and carry out planned development of the cities. This can be used to strengthen the transportation as well as the communication system of the city. It also includes response to emergency system in a moment of the crisis. Now, let's take quick recap what we have studied in our lesson number 10, Urbanization in Module 2. In the beginning, we took information about the effects of urbanization. So, due to the growth and the development in the urban area, the features or the characteristic of the particular region changes. As a result, we can find various or drastic changes in the urban area. Also, we have studied that there are many advantages of urbanization. So are the disadvantages. Also, we have studied about the advantages of urbanization. So the advantages of urbanization such as social harmony, modernization, amenities and facility. So the social harmony takes place just because a particular place has increased in secondary, tertiary and quaternary occupation. More and more people get attracted towards that particular place. So due to the various occupation, economic activity increases. It generates employment opportunity for the people. As a result, growth takes place. So the different people stay together. As a result, cultural, social custom and traditions are exchanged as a people from the different region. Cultures and the tradition lives together in a peace and harmony in the urban area. Also, we have studied about the modernization. People migrate to urban areas, their wisdom, skills and knowledge are also exchanged. Urban settlement gets an advantages of new ideas, technologies, facilities and higher standard of living. Urban areas provide wide range of amenities and facilities. As a result, the lifestyle of the people changes. It becomes more comfortable and easy. All facilities such as educational, medical, recreational as well as the transportation facilities are available in the urban areas. At the end, we have studied about the problems of urbanization. So, the problems of urbanization such as slums, traffic jams, pollution and the crime. Nowadays, the problems of slums are goes on increasing. Slum is one of the major problems in the urban areas. Because of the rapid increase in population and the growth and development in the urban areas, the city gets overcrowded. This leads to the lack of housing facilities to the common man. Common man cannot able to afford the higher land prices. As a result, they started constructing their houses in open areas. These give rise to the increase of slum in the city. Then we studied about the traffic jam. Due to the overpopulation in the city, the public transportation is overcrowded. This results in an increase of private vehicle, which leads to the traffic jam due to too many private vehicles as well as the public transportation system. The pollution is one of the major problems arises in the cities. Air pollution, water pollution, noise pollution and land pollution are goes on increasing due to the increasing population. Then the crime. Due to the migration of a population in an increasing number, all the people do not get employment opportunities. Many people try to earn money by illegal ways. As a result, it gives rise to the crime. So, student, in this module, we have studied about the effects of urbanization, advantages of urbanization as well as the disadvantages of urbanization, also known as the problems of urbanization.